What is up, you beautiful people? We just touched down on the legendary Sani Pass. Now, it's the only road link between KwaZulu-Natal and Lesotho, and although the weather does seem like it's cooling down, I am so excited because the outdoor activities and leisure is just about to heat up. Let's go check it out. Well, Mr. Vezi, I can't thank you enough for inviting me here. I mean, I've just been here for a few minutes, but I'm already in absolute awe. But can you tell me more about the beauty of Dr. Nkosazana Dlamini-Zuma's municipality and some of the history behind this place?
The Dr. Nkosazana Dlamini-Zuma local municipality is located in the southern Drakensberg of KwaZulu-Natal, in the Herikwala district municipality, situated in the border of the Republic of South Africa and the Kingdom of Lesotho. It's a beautiful place, a wonderful place. Not because of its namesake, but because of what you'd find there as tourist attraction areas. You have the Sani Pass. The Sani Pass is a world-famous road that leads from the Republic of South Africa into the Kingdom of Lesotho. It passes through the mountains. It's the highest pass in South Africa. It's a breathtaking drive. Only 4x4 cars are allowed there.
Oh, look, I can't thank you enough for encouraging everybody to come out here and explore this magic, as well as for the work that you are doing to preserve the natural and authentic beauty of this land.
Thank you. Thank you.
Michael, I'm so excited and I can't thank you enough for having me at this fine establishment. But I'm not out there in the beautiful abyss exploring all this landscape. What can I expect to do right here at the resort?
Well, it's just so much to do, you know, but it all depends on the type of weather. So that's why we try to cooperate as much as we can do, and we try to adapt as best as we can due to different weather conditions. So we have a kids club, we also have a whole set of other activities for the adults, and that ranges from bingo, even soccer outside, and even games night, or even a general knowledge quiz. We do have a wild stacked entertainment program with full of activities.
Oh man, it sounds so exciting. I cannot wait. And I think my first activity is going to be horse riding. So what can I expect for experience, and what should I look out for?
You can just expect the beautiful scenery that we have to offer. Actually, when you're out there, it's quite nice if you go past near our beautiful waterfall, which is pretty close to the property itself, about 1.1K, so it's not too hectic. With a little river rushing down there, it's absolutely gorgeous.
I can't wait, man. Let's go. Oh, what an incredible experience to start off this trip right here in the Sani Pass. And we took this beautiful galleon steed out into the valley, watching over some snow-capped mountains, viewing an incredible waterfall just to top it all off. And I can't thank you enough. But it's on to the next adventure, and tomorrow morning we are literally taking to the skies. Let's get it. Now, I've journeyed through the foothills of the Sani Pass via horseback, but now it's time to take in this beautiful landscape from a new perspective. It's time to go up, it's time to go high, it's time to paraglide. Hans, I'm so excited for this. I've never done it before, so this is literally a bucket list item for me. But before we get into it, where does your passion for paragliding come from, and how long have you been doing this?
I started flying 32 years ago. But for a long time before that, even as a kid, I'd wanted to fly. So what's happened now is we're basically one of the biggest paragliding schools in South Africa. We're, I think, the second oldest paragliding school in South Africa. What we do is we do tandem flights, like what we're going to do with you, for people with zero experience. And we just take you for a nice flight, have a good time, show you what it's all about.
Okay, well, look, I'm not looking to do anything crazy. I just want to have a good time. So let's keep it easy, let's keep it safe, and let's get it.
Come along.
Oh man, that was incredible. I can't think of a better way to just take in the beauty out here. I mean, such a unique perspective. We got to see all the way through to the Drakensberg mountain range, the snow-capped mountains, the lush rolling hills, but absolute magic. And now I think I've worked up an appetite, so there's only one thing to do. Let's go higher. Let's go all the way to the top of the Sani Pass. Woo! Look where we are, people, surrounded by snow-capped mountains right here in the Sekeringe village, greeted by beautiful people that are so accepting and inviting. I mean, come on, this is just like living in an absolute dream. 3,000 meters of altitude, what more could you ask for? Woo! Wow, I mean, talk about taking a dining experience to new heights. Paulo, this place is absolutely incredible. But what can you tell me about this fine establishment's history?
It was bought by Rapamits Maleke in 1992 from a family in Anderbeck. It was first established by the people who used this pass to trade in Mkhotlo. So they decided to make a little inn where they could rest, have something to drink and eat before driving to Mkhotlo the following morning.
I can imagine after all these years, so many people have still stepped foot in this beautiful place. But what can we expect in this day and age when it comes to fine dining on a beautiful balcony like this?
I mean, the highest pub is the best place to have a cold one, hot chocolates, cappuccinos, and then the food also. We have our famous pizza, our famous Basotho lamb stew, curries and burgers. There's a lot to choose from.
KZN, what can I say? This entire trip has been an absolute dream. I think there's been so many bucket list firsts for me that I got to tick off when it comes to the Lesotho region and all the beauty of those people there. Sani Pass, paragliding, experiencing snow, exploring this beautiful landscape via horseback. I mean, the list goes on and I've literally felt like I've been living in an absolute dream. I can't thank you, KZN, enough for having me and the beautiful people of the Zulu Kingdom. This is definitely a place that you want to come visit all year round.